Hi, I'm Jamie Edwards. This is Magic 105.4. I'm actually here at the Groucho Club for the launch of Queen 40 Years. It is an amazing book, this, with loads of different memorabilia and artifacts included within the book. Well, actually, it's replicas, but I have got some of the real things here, including the Red Special, which is Brian May's very own personal guitar. It is absolutely incredible. The little whammy bar here is apparently made up of a bicycle stand and the end of his mum's knitting needle, which actually, if you look really closely, you can see it really is. It's got two wormholes in the neck as well. Absolutely fascinating little exhibit here. We've got so many posters and records from there. You've got the Made in Heaven album, which Brian tells us is one of his favourites, and he absolutely loves the song Made in Heaven. You've also got some, if you follow me over here, also got the British hit singles. Bohemian Rhapsody voted the best hit single ever, which, let's face it, it really is, isn't it? And even here, handwritten lyrics to some of Queen's songs as well. It really is an amazing exhibition here.
You can even see people like me.
Yeah. Thank you, Brian. And even got the MTV award as well. If you're interested in the book, then make sure you go out and get it. It looks a little bit like this.
Cheers, Foxy. Yes, I am actually at the world famous Groucho Club. You can probably hear the cutlery banging away in the background there.
Hello, Mr. Foxy.
Brian May is with me, and he's saying hello to you, Foxy. There you go. We're actually here to launch 40 Years of Queen, this incredible book that's got loads of different artifacts and memorabilia. That
it is incredible, isn't it? I'm quite taken aback myself. And I mean, obviously, I was part of the planning of it, but when I first held it in my hands, I was quite amazed. It really is such a lot of fun, isn't it, the book?
It's brilliant, because there's so many little bits in there that you'd never have got to see.
It's like an interactive toy more than a book, isn't it, really? It's a picture book with things that you pull out and look at and unfold and fold and try and get back in. It's hilarious, really.
Yes, actually. We're going to talk about a lot of the music that you guys have done over the years, an amazing catalogue of music that pretty much makes up the magic playlist, I have to say. So we're going to start off with a kind of magic.
Right.
Just tell me, you know, how did this song come about?
It came from the Highlander film, and it's Roger's composition, and he took one of the lines from the film and spun it into the song, because the hero of the film, who's Connor MacLeod, if you remember, and he's immortal, he says, they say, you know, how do you manage to appear in the 15th century and still appear young now? And he says, it's a kind of magic.
Let's just take you back to the beginning. 1971 is where it all started for you. You guys had been in other bands, wasn't quite working out, and then Freddie persuaded you to let him be the lead singer, a flamboyant lead singer.
Yes, he did. He said, do it one more time with me and we'll all be stars, or something like that. So we went, oh, okay.
You kind of got to give him credit. He did have vision.
He really did. Vision is what he had, and he had persistence and flair and an amazing talent.
Listen, Brian, real pleasure. Thank you for everything that you've done for Magic. And, well, here's A Winter's Tale.
Brilliant.